Hare Krishna. If we consider scripture to be like a vast territory, then sometimes if you have to navigate through a vast, complicated territory, then a map is very helpful to understand, okay, where does this road lead to from here? Where does this turn take us? What is over here? What is there? So similarly, a map can help us to navigate scripture. That means that if we can understand how or why one verse follows another verse, why one section follows another section, why one chapter follows another chapter, if we can understand the thought flow of scripture, that can help us to navigate scripture better. And that way we can get the lay of scripture, lay of the land. We can know overall, say, what the Bhagavad-Gita is telling if we can map its verses. And of course, the Bhagavad-Gita may not seem to be very big. It just has 700 verses. But it's like a small land, but it's a tough terrain. It is filled with ups and downs that can make navigation difficult. Sometimes understanding the flow of the Bhagavad-Gita can seem so difficult that some people just lose heart. It doesn't make sense to me. So now sometimes some territory may be very difficult to map. But suppose we have got some land as inheritance, and that land contains some gold. And if gold is there everywhere in the territory, then even if we find it difficult to map the whole land, if we just mine it, if we just dig wherever we can and we get the treasure from there, then that itself is wonderful. So similarly, the Bhagavad Gita is filled with instructions, with guidelines, with insights that are like mines. That the verses of the Gita, if we contemplate them, analyze them, even if one verse we do such contemplation analysis, and of course not just analysis but also application, the way we mine the Gita is not just by analyzing the Gita but by applying the Gita in our lives, then even one verse of the Gita can actually give us so much enrichment that it can constantly fulfill us. That's what this enrichment through mining the Gita is, what is demonstrated at the end of the Gita by Sanjay. Sanjay, at the end of the Gita, is applying the Gita's essential directive to remember Krishna. Tatcha samsmritya samsmritya rupam atyadbhutam harehe vismayo me mahan rajan rishyami cha puna puna. The Bhagavad-Gita tells us to remember Krishna. That's one of the most consistent instructions in the Gita. And Sanjay applies that, and by doing that, he is thrilled repeatedly, incessantly. So sometimes if we find that mapping of scripture is difficult for us, still we can focus on the mining of scripture. We don't have to understand necessarily the flow of each verse and the next verse. If we can, wonderful. We can make all efforts through that, but if we can't, we don't have to become disheartened. The essence of the Bhagavad Gita can be got even by applying one verse of the Gita, even by mining one verse. So even if we don't understand the intricacies of the Gita, if we can understand its essential principle, that let us try to remember Krishna with love, then whatever wealth the Gita is meant to give us, it will give all to us and enrich us eternally. Thank you. Hare Krishna.